Hi everyone, welcome to Naptime Nutrition. I'm Yaffi Lvova, registered dietitian, nutritionist, and owner of Baby Bloom Nutrition and Toddler Test Kitchen. And today I'm coming at you live to talk about lectins. You have probably heard about this scary thing in your food. Okay, let's talk about it because it's not really all that scary. Oh, I always give you a spoiler. Spoiler alert, don't worry. So lectins, what are they? Lectins are a compound that's in all different types of food, but they are most often found in higher quantities in legumes, including peanuts, grains, and nightshades. Nightshades include tomatoes, potatoes, eggplants, bell peppers. You may have heard of nightshades in a negative sense as well, and I'll talk about that. So why do we know about lectins? Well, certain diets, the Whole 30, for example, have really been demonizing lectins lately, saying that they're an anti-nutrient. They prevent other foods from being absorbed. They cause gut issues. They cause diarrhea and vomiting and general pain. So is this true? There is truth to it, and there is a whole lot of not truth to it. So let's really dissect it. A lectin is a carbohydrate binding protein. Well, that clears everything up. It has a lot of roles, but what lectins are most known for are mediating first-line defenses against invading microorganisms, so they keep you from getting sick. They modulate inflammatory and autoreactive processes, which means that it keeps the body moving in a healthy way, rather than reacting to minor stimuli with an autoimmune reaction. It helps your body to move along in an appropriate fashion. There is possibly a role in cancer therapy. They could be helpful in eradicating cancer. So they also have a role in cell adhesion and glycoprotein synthesis, both of which are really important for health. So there's your basic what is a lectin. What's the bad news? Well, they reduce ability to absorb nutrients. That's why they're called an anti-nutrient. And I have a caveat to this, so stay tuned. They may cause diarrhea and vomiting. They may cause cancer. Okay, I'm going to give you the caveat to that one right away. There was a study that showed that I think it was peanut lectins specifically cross over into the blood and cause cancer. Well, if you look at the actual study and how it was pulled off, there were cancer cells that already existed. A high dose of pure lectins was put right on top of the already existing cancer cells, and they grew. So that doesn't really tell us what's going to happen in the body. It doesn't really tell us anything. It tells us that in a lab, if you put lectins right on top of cancer cells, then they will grow. But you know what? There are a lot of things that will cause cancer cells to grow that will happen in a lab and won't necessarily happen in the human body. So now let's talk about the best news, okay? That was the bad news. Now here we have the good news, which is really good. Lectins are decreased in the food by up to 95%, possibly more, with any kind of cooking or fermenting or processing at all. So let's talk about peanuts. Are you eating raw peanuts? Probably not. Most peanuts that you have access to have been roasted, and the same with nuts and the same with grains. We're not eating raw grains. We're eating cooked grains. We're eating processed grains. You're not going into a wheat field and pulling off a piece of wheat and eating it. Our body can't really digest it that way anyway, which is why we process it, why we cook it. Okay, legumes. Are you eating raw beans? Okay, sometimes we eat edamame, which can come steamed. And steam doesn't really do much to reduce lectins, but if you look at the amount that you're eating, it is likely not a concern in the slightest. Most beans are going to either be canned, which the canning process reduces lectins by up to 95%. If you buy them dry, you're soaking them, you're cooking them, you're boiling them. A trick is you can put them in the slow cooker, cover them in water and put them on high for 3 hours. That destroys the lectins. That means that they don't act as an anti-nutrient because they don't exist anymore. That means that they're not causing diarrhea and vomiting. It means that they are not causing cancer. And in fact, all of these foods that have lectins in them, the ones that I mentioned, the ones that are highest in lectins, actually are a great source of B vitamins and iron and fiber. These are nutrients that we need in order to stay healthy. So it's important to not eliminate foods that may or may not contain lectins, because the truth is that you're cooking them anyway. The way that we process them, the way that we prepare them before we eat them, means that it's not going to cause an issue in your nutrition or in your body. Fermentation also reduces lectins. So for instance, if you were to take edamame, which is soybeans, and you want to ferment them, you may end up with soy sauce or miso or tempeh. These are all fermented soy, which means it does not have those lectins. Sprouting can reduce lectins by about 59%. So if you're having sourdough, that's a really big thing. I might do a segment only on sourdough because it seems to be a huge food fad right now. But part of the reason why people are fermenting. The truth is that if you're having bread, it already is processed into flour. It's already cooking. So we'll have to look in, you'll have to stay tuned to see if sourdough really is necessary as far as improving your health when you're eating bread. So there's your good news. Okay, yes, lectins exist. Yes, there are bad things about them, and there are also great things about them. And they are, for the most part, eliminated by the cooking processes that we use before we eat them. So you do not have to be wary about lectins. You don't have to eliminate beans from your diet. And if you do notice that you are having some gastrointestinal discomfort while eating these foods, you may try to eat them in a different way. Maybe sometimes you do need to eliminate certain foods that cause you discomfort, but eliminating all grains and all legumes and all nightshades because of fear of lectins has proven to be ineffective. So if you have any questions, please contact a local non-diet registered dietitian, such as myself, in your area. And I'm happy to set you up with someone if you have any questions and you don't know where to look. So PM me. You can also find me on babybloomnutrition.com. I'm on Instagram at toddler.test.kitchen and pinterest.com/Yaffi. Please comment. Let me know what you think. Let me know any subjects that you think I should cover or if you have any questions. And if you are local to the Phoenix area, come join me for Toddler Test Kitchen, which is running at CREATE, which is the Arizona Science Center, as well as Awesome Toddlers Indoor Playground in Santan Mall in Gilbert. You can find all dates and registration links at toddlertestkitchen.net. So see you next week for Naptime Nutrition. Thank you for coming to listen about lectins, and I look forward to hearing your comments.